Hey Fratcom, this is Max Forte back with another FIV, Fragrant Informational Video Part 2. Just about almost 2 weeks ago I did Part 1 and I covered a few things that people have been asking over the past couple of years, and I compiled a few other things that I thought would be really interesting for someone who's starting collecting right now or has questions about fragrances in general, so I hope this is another helpful video. But before I get into that, let me talk to you about my scent of the day. Today, it was Silver Mountain Water. Amazing spring day, beautiful, sunny. This thing here is a miracle. Women really seem to love this. It's a compliment monster. It's a woody floral musk. You can't go wrong. Silver Mountain Water, it made my top 10 spring for 2016, so it's a really great fragrance, a very solid release from Creed. So let's get into the FIV part two. Without any further ado, let's jump right into it. Alright, so the first thing we're going to cover is fragrance types and concentration. So there's going to be a chart that's going to appear right here, right around me, and I'm going to break it down for you. So the first category is an aftershave. You know, some people use, balm, and some people like to wear the alcoholic stuff, you know, the aftershave that's almost like fragrance, but it's really aftershave. You splash it on and you splatter on your hands and then you just put it on your face. So basically, those aftershaves are 1-3% in concentration of compound, fragrant or organic or synthetic compound. So that 1-3% will last you about a half an hour to maybe an hour tops. So that's the first concentration. The second concentration that we know is another very faint concentration. It's called eau de cologne. 5% at the most in concentration of fragrant compound. And it'll last about a couple hours, 2-3 if you're lucky. So that's the second category. The third category is the one that's most known to man, which is eau de toilette. Now eau de toilette will have 5-15% in concentration and it'll last about 6-8 hours tops on your skin. And last but not least, before we get into the last one, we have the eau de parfum. The eau de parfum concentration will be about 15-20% fragrant compound and it'll last about 10 plus hours. That's, you know, most parfum concentrations will give you those kind of numbers. And last but not least is the parfum extra or pure parfum, which will give you 20+ up to 30% in concentration, which will last a real long time, 12, 15 plus hours on your skin, well into the next day. So that's the breakdown. You're gonna have your little chart that's gonna show up right here, right around me. And those were the breakdowns for your most common fragrant concentrations. Next thing we're gonna talk about is the most prominent classifications and categories known into the fragrance world. And these are six categories. So the first classification or category is the floral, which is associated mostly, as the name implies, florals, and they're mostly associated with women, feminine scents. And these categories give you, for the most part, you know, flowers like jasmine, rose, carnation, geranium, those kind of flowers, or white flowers like lily, lily of the valley, so forth and so on. With those floral categories or classifications, sometimes you find exotic flowers like moonflowers, freesia, gardenia, you know, so forth and so on. And they're usually embellished by some citrus accord and a little bit of a woodiness, but not too much. So the main player here are florals. The second category or classification are the fruity one, which fruity, as the name implies, is mostly around fruity notes. And you have warmer fruits like passion fruits, pineapples, apples, apricot, peach, things of that nature. And it's also usually embellished by a subcategory of citruses. The third category includes the classification or category of chypre, which includes mossy notes, oak moss, clary sage. You can think of the color green, just like my shirt. So these cheaper fragrances I usually associate with outdoors, things that are very aromatic, but again, very green. Patchouli, clary sage, lavender, and oak moss are usually the prominent notes in this category. The fourth category is the fougère, which is really associated with powerhouse fragrances from the 70s and 80s for men. So the fougère usually has a very prominent lavender note in them, with a green, grassy, oaky, and mossy feel to them. Very herbal, if you will. This is one of my favorite categories. Some of these fragrances could be rather heavy, with a little enamelic undertone to them. Next category is the orientals. The orientals, you have a lot of spiciness, some precious woods, It'll give you sweet nuances, almost get into the gourmandish territory. And this is also another category that I really love. The Oriental is the exotic category or classification of the bunch. You're gonna find exotic flowers, exotic woods, you're gonna find your vanillas, your most opulent and resinous fragrances in the fragrance world are usually from this category. Last but not least, you have the oceanic / aquatic category, which has been really popular over the last 20-25 years. You know, these are your Acqua di Gio's, all your sport flankers. It's the fragrances that contain that sea note, that sea breeze. You know, they try to emulate things like air. You know, they tend to be very synthetic, but some companies actually master them very well to make them as natural as possible. Now, within those six classifications or categories, if you will, there are subcategories or sub-classifications within the fragrance wheel created by Michael Edwards, which I'm going to show you right now. You know, with Eastern meets Western world, the addition of oud over the past, you know, few years that's been really, really big into our fragrance community, you can see that there are subcategories. You know, you're going to have your Oriental Fougere, your Fruity Florals, you know, your Woody Aquatics, so forth and so on. Pretty much, you know, combining, mix and matching some of these categories to create new subcategories and subclassifications, you know, the possibilities are infinite, and it's just a great thing for us that love fragrance. So we're gonna talk about now the staging or the fragrance pyramid, the notes, you know, how the fragrance transitions, you know, from top to heart to the base or the bottom note, you know, the dry down, if you will. So we're going to talk about the pyramid, the transition. As the fragrance develops, most of them do transition. Some fragrances are linear, or you have a combination of notes, and that's what you get from beginning to end. But for the most part, they have a pyramid, which will appear right next to me. And with this pyramid, you're going to have your top notes, your heart notes, and your dry down. And it's going to show you here the notes that are most prominent to each of these categories, okay? So the top notes are usually more citrus notes, and these citrus notes usually evaporate or expand within 30 minutes tops. Then you're gonna get into the heart, which is a transitional period that's gonna get you from 30 minutes to 2 hours until you get to the dry down, which usually your woods, your vanillas, you know, the more resinous, more richer components, which will last the remainder of the life of the fragrance, which sometimes could take up to 8 to 10 hours for the most part. So this is, again, it's a general idea. I'm gonna have the pyramid right next to me, which will show you this transition and which notes or chords are most prominent to each one of these transitional parts of the fragrance, from top to heart to dry down. Last thing I'd like to cover in this FIV is understanding fragrances, how they work for you. You know, usually if you go to a general store and you smell the test strip that they give you, you are getting the introduction, the opening of a fragrance. That's what's gonna stay on that piece of paper. The paper is not it's not your body, it's not skin, it's not gonna transition, and that's how those assays from those stores catch you, from that opening. If a fragrance has a phenomenal opening, chances are you're gonna love it, you're gonna wanna buy it. So be careful, get a sample, try on your skin, make sure it works for you with your body chemistry, make sure it works with your environment, and it's doing exactly what you thought that opening was going to do. That's very important. The next thing I'd like to reiterate is that seasons. You see all these top videos, you know, winter, fall, spring, summer. So basically what we're doing, myself included, I'm giving you fragrances that really work great for me in that time frame of the year. And with that in mind, for example, for cooler seasons like late fall and winter, you know, I try to go with darker, richer, more resinous, more spicy oriental scents. Those will do very well for me. You know, I'm in New England, Connecticut, for example. You know, it's very cold, and you need fragrances that have some depth to break and you know, withstand these heavy winters. That's why I choose those fragrances. Now, when you go into spring and summer, you want your citruses, your aquatics, you know, fragrances that are fruitier, maybe a little bit of florals. They're gonna work phenomenal with the heat. They're not gonna be clawing. They're not gonna offend anybody around you, including yourself. And they're gonna make you feel invigorated, fresh, and it's gonna evoke, you know, playfulness, and you know, those kind of things that are associated with warm and sun and that type of vibe that you want to achieve in those time of the years. So that's pretty much how I choose my fragrances, and this is a little bit of a tip, if you will, for you to try to emulate and to incorporate in your wardrobe, your fragrance wardrobe, if you will. And guys, this is it for today. At the end of the day, take this with a grain of salt. This is my opinion. It's, you know, what I've compiled over the years based on these questions and these, topics that I was asked. You know, whatever works for you, whatever works with your skin, your environment is great. If it makes you feel great and you smell fantastic and you love the way you smell, rock it. By all means, you know, make it work. You know, if it's, you know, the middle of summer and you like wearing a fragrance like Musk Ravageur and it makes you feel fantastic, by all means, do it. You know, this is what works for me. These are the concepts and the principles that I use for myself. You know, give it a whirl. If it works for you, then great. Over the past few years, I've utilized these principles and they have worked phenomenally for me. So I'm just sharing them with you. This was Max Forte with another FIV. You know, maybe I'll do a part three. I'm not sure yet. You know, hopefully I'll do maybe a part three or even a part four. But for now, this is it. If you have any questions, you know, feel free to email me at maxforte@gmail.com. You know, drop down in the comments below if you have anything that I didn't touch upon that you have questions on. Let me know. Maybe I'll do a part three of it sooner than later. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Hit that like button if you haven't. Please subscribe for a lot more from the channel. Again, this was Max Forte. I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.